Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing exponential and logarithmic equations. Let's do some examples of solving equations. Part A, we have 2 to the x minus 2 equals 4 to the x plus 3. Let's work this one out. So the idea is when you see a problem like this, you want to think about whether or not you can write it using the same base. Because we have a base of 2 on the left-hand side, we should think, hey, how can we write 4 as a power of 2? Well, 2 squared is equal to 4, so let's go ahead and do that in our first step. So we have 2 to the x minus 2 is equal to 4, which is 2 squared, parentheses, and this is to the x plus 3. So then we have 2 to the x minus 2, and then this is a really key step. We have to actually multiply the 2 by both of these terms, okay? We actually distribute. So 2 times x is 2x. Then 2 times 3 is 6. There's a step I skipped, okay? The step I skipped was this one. This is equal to 2 to the 2 parentheses x plus 3. The properties of exponents say that you multiply the 2 and the x plus 3, okay? And so this is the step I skipped. And then you distribute 2x plus 6. Good stuff. Now we're in a really good place because whenever you have the same base on both sides like this, you can drop the bases. And so you get x minus 2 is equal to 2x plus 6. And there's a bunch of ways to solve this. I'm going to go ahead and subtract the x. So we have minus 2 equals 2x minus x is x, and then plus 6. Then we can subtract the 6, so minus 6 minus 6, these cancel. So we end up with x equals, so minus 2 minus 6 is minus 8. And so the answer to this problem is x equals minus 8. Really nice. Let's go ahead and do another example. Part B, we have e to the 4 plus x equals 9. Let's go ahead and solve this equation solution. Let's start by writing it again. So we have e 4 plus x, and then equal to 9. Now I left some room here on purpose because now what we're going to do is we're going to take the natural log of both sides like this, ln, ln. And the reason you do that is because you're looking for x and it's in the exponent, and this will allow you to bring it down. Because there is a super powerful formula that says if you have the natural log of e to the x, that's equal to x. This is super, super powerful. In this particular case, this whole piece here, this 4 plus x, this is our x. So basically this goes away and we get 4 plus x equals the natural log of 9. And then we're just looking for x. So we have a positive 4 here. So we can just subtract it from both sides like this. And so we get x equals the natural log of 9 and then minus 4. A really useful technique whenever you have an e like this and you're trying to get, you know, the variables, just take the natural log of both sides and you can get rid of the e, and then you can solve for x. Let's go ahead and do one more example. Part C, we have to solve the equation 3 times the natural log of x plus 1 minus 2 equals 1. Let's work through this one. Solution. So whenever you have a single logarithm in an equation, you want to isolate the single logarithm. So we'll start by adding 2 to both sides. So plus 2, plus 2. So these cancel. We get 3 times the natural log of x plus 1. And that's equal to 1 plus 2, which is 3. Now this natural log is being multiplied by 3. So to get rid of the 3, we just divide both sides by 3. So divide by 3, divide by 3. We end up with the natural log of x plus 1 equals 1. And here's where we do our super powerful move. This is the key point. We want to get rid of the ln. So there is a formula that tells us that if you have e to the natural log of x, that's equal to x. This is a super powerful formula. It is super useful. And so basically what we're going to do is we're going to introduce an e by putting it here and by putting it here. This process is called exponentiation. We're exponentiating both sides of the equation. Super powerful. And look, these basically cancel. And so you're left with x plus 1 equals e to the 1, which is just e. To finish, we just subtract 1. And so we end up with x equals e minus 1. And that would be the solution to this equation. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.